Hi guys, Tejas here with another video on fun math. When I started the channel, I have created a video on multinomial theorem, and so many numbers commented that that explanation is not this much nice. So I have decided to create another video on multinomial theorem. In this video, I will show you the proof that the binomial theorem, or to expand a binomial equation. Or to expand a binomial raised to the power of n, we should take nc0 a power n plus nc1 a power n minus 1, or with a constant term, with a general term, ncr a power r b power n minus r. In this video, I will show you why we should take only that and why can't we take any other. Okay, let's get this video started. First, how can we prove the binomial theorem? Okay, let's take with a very familiar example. A plus b cubed. Instead of a plus b raised to the power of n directly, first let's see a plus b cubed. And how can we find the general term? Okay, first, in a plus b cubed, you can write that like a plus b into a plus b into a plus b. Now here, if you multiply these terms, in every term, you will multiply any of these two terms from the first binomial. You have written this binomial three times, right? You will take any term from the first binomial and you will multiply that with any term from the second binomial, and you will multiply that with any term from the third binomial. Or we can tell that it is similar to a permutation. And it is similar to the permutation only if you label this. Means if you label this a1 plus b1, a2 plus b2 times a3 plus b3, then it will be a permutation of 6. And you should choose any from that 6. But here it is somewhat of different than the permutation, because here we have the common elements in the first binomial is a plus b, and the second binomial is also a plus b, and the third binomial is also a plus b. If we have different terms, you can write like a1, a2, a3. But here, it is same a cubed. Instead of a1, a2, a3, it is the same a cubed. Okay, similarly, if we take the term a square b, we can tell that like a1, a2, b3, or a1, b2, a3, or b1, a2, a3. But here, the terms are same. What we should do is, first find for a1, a2, first find the total possibilities to get either a1, a2, b3, or a1, a2, a1, b2, a3, or b1, a2, a3. We will say possibility for getting those three. Okay, those three are just three possibilities. Those are just three possibilities. Okay, but you can arrange them too. Means you can write a1, a2, b3 as a1, b3 and a2. And if we consider all those, you will get it is a permutation of three. So you will get 3 factorial ways. But here we have 2 a square terms. So you should divide that by 2 factorial. Means in 2 factorial ways, it will be the same. It will be the same in 2 factorial ways. Right? For 2 factorial ways, it will be the same. For 2 factorial ways, a square b will be same. So you should divide by 2 factorial, which is nothing but 3 factorial by 2 factorial. And 1 factorial is just 1, right? So you can add 1 factorial also. It will become 3 factorial by 1 factorial times 2 factorial. Or it is nothing but 3c1. Therefore, the coefficient of a square b is nothing but 3c1. Similarly, if we take the expansion a plus b whole power n, now we can enter to the a plus b whole power n term. Now, if we take the term a power r b power n minus r, and we should find its coefficient. Now let's see how can we find that. Okay, for finding the coefficient of the term a power r b power n minus r, we will approach that in the same way. First, we will see the total terms, which are nothing but n. If we take r s and n minus A or B differently, you'll get a total of n terms. So n terms, you should arrange those n terms in any way, right? So it will have n factorial ways, or the permutation of n choose n. You'll have n factorial ways, and it is if we label differently, you'll get n factorial ways. But we have or s, means the or terms are the same. So you should divide that by r factorial ways, means you'll have r factorial ways of getting same terms. So you should divide that by r factorial ways. And if I do that, if I divide it by r factorial ways, it will become n factorial by r factorial. Similarly, we have n minus r b's. So you should divide that by n minus r factorial too. So it will become n factorial by r factorial times n minus r factorial. And this is how to approach finding the coefficient of the general term in a binomial expansion, or the coefficient of a power r b power n minus r. It is nothing but n factorial by r factorial times n minus r factorial, or it is n c r. So the general term in a plus b to the power of n is summation of r is equal to 0 to n, means r can go from 0 to n, means at least you can take 0 s. You can't take negative 1 s or negative 2 s, right? In a binomial expansion, we can't take negative s. So at least you can take 0 s, and at the maximum you can take n s. Because if you take greater than n, means if you take n plus 1 s, then you should take negative 1 b's, which is not possible. So it will be summation of r is equal to 0 to n, n c r a power r b power n minus r, as NCR is the coefficient of a power r b power n minus r. Now we have sufficient knowledge to enter the multinomial theorem. Let's see what is the general term in a multinomial expansion. Okay, before we have seen a plus b to the power of n. Now let's see how can we expand a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus and so on until at, total of t terms raised to the power of n. You can call this ftnomial, or generally you can call it a multinomial, because t can be varying. As we discussed previously, the general coefficient here will be nothing but n factorial by r1 factorial, r2 factorial, r3 factorial, and so on until rt factorial. If we take the powers of a1, a2, a3, and so on until at as r1, r2, r3, and so on until rt respectively. And the condition is that the power should be equal to n. The sum of all the powers should be equal to n, as in binomial theorem. The sum of the powers should be equal, because if I take in the case a plus b into a plus b into a plus b, or a plus b cubed, you can take any term from any of those binomial theorems. From any of those binomial theorems, you should take just one term. So from the first you will get 1, and the second binomial you will get 2, and the third binomial you will get 1. If I add those, you will get a total of 3. So the possible power is, the possible degree is 3. Similarly here, the sum of all the degrees should be equal to n. The total of the powers should be equal to n. So r1 plus r2 plus r3 plus and so on until rt is nothing but n. And how can we prove that the coefficient is n factorial by r1 factorial, r2 factorial, and so on until rt factorial? Okay, if we take the general term, not the coefficient, just the, or if we take only the general term without taking the coefficient, then you will have the subterms as a1 to the power of r1, a2 to the power of r2, and a3 to the power of r3, and so on until at to the power of rt. And here we have the same r1 a1s and r2 a2s and r3 a3s. Those all will be the same terms. So you should divide by those factorials. You should divide by factorial of number of same terms, or degree of same terms. Means a1 degree is r1, so you should divide by r1 factorial. a2 degree is r2, so you should divide by r2 factorial. And if I do all that, you'll get general term in the expansion a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus and so on until at raised to the power of n is nothing but summation such that r1 plus r2 plus r3 and so on until rt is equal to n. N factorial by R1 factorial, R2 factorial and so on until RT factorial, A1 to the power of R1 plus A2 to the power of R2 plus and so on until A2 to the power of RT. And this will be the general term of a multinomial expansion. Okay guys, this is what the multinomial theorem is. I hope you understand this time. If not, comment down below which part you haven't understand, and I will explain that again in another video. Okay, this is for today's video. See you later.